You can start.
Okay. I welcome everyone to this auspicious event. I welcome every staff, jury members, and the participants of mechanical A section. I invite finally our flame secretary, Mr. Rakul, to carry on. May give an introduction part.
Thank you, Alan. I once again warmly welcome you all to the Mech Talk 2 of Ignite 2021. So you will be having a presentation of 10 or 12 slides, and you can explain it up to 5 minutes, and you can have queries up to 2 minutes. So I think that will be fine for you all people. Is that fine? You can just chat in the chat box as yes. There is no reply. Yeah, okay. Anyone other than Alan? Yeah, fine. So now you all can switch on your videos. So let us take a screenshot of this event for an proof. So can more people switch on your video?
Photograph. All students, please switch on your video for having a photo. Just for an evidence, quickly, please go ahead. All of you, switch on your video quickly. Very handsome beauties. Switch on your video quickly. Ajit Kumar, Ilavarasan, Kishore, Jeeva, Bhubalan, all of you, quick, quick, quick. Deepan, Giri, Viral Mano, switch on your video, quick. Deepan, looking smart. All others, quick, quick. Nahanan, where are you? Quick. Nirmal, Jeeva, why you are hiding? Quick, quick. We don't have sufficient time. Quickly switch on your video, Nelson. Pardila, where is Pardila? I can't see him. Fayaz, Harish. Quickly switch on your video.
Hello.
Okay, I think Alan, you can take a snapshot.
Yeah.
Otherwise, it is there in the video. I think we can able to cut. Rahul, can we proceed? Rahul? Am I audible or not, first of all, Alan?
Yes, sir. You're audible.
Yes, sir. You're audible.
Okay. I think it is okay. Over to all. Thank you for making this to happen. So, it's a really fun, fine day. Okay. I'm very happy to see you all in this good platform. This is a great opportunity given by our Mechanical Engineering Students Association Flame. So, we are in the Mech Talk 2 today. And we had one such presentation in the art semester. And all your participation were been highly appreciated by the department. And I think 100% participation was there from third year A section. All have received your certificates too. And this time the Flame has extended its opportunity for us to once again present your topic. This time I think you all have come up with a lot of innovative topics which is closely related with emerging areas. So we have our flame, one of the flame coordinators, Professor Venkatraman sir. He has joined with us today, and without his kind help and the planning, these kind of programs are really not able to organize. And one more thing, the student secretary Rakul, you all know, very familiar, right? From the putting an SMS to creating a Google link and making this event in a recordable one and to remain back in the future. All such efforts are being taken by the secretary of the flame. That's a very good activity that he is doing. Still, he has planned a lot of things for your improvement. So the program like this will give you lot of insights towards your inner skills, to bring out the inner skills. So with this juncture, I would also like to congratulate and welcome the students of final year D section, Mr. Karthik, who has recently placed at Accenture Aspire Systems. Okay, and he will moderate this session along with Rahul. Okay, and one more student I have invited from final year, Mr. Dinesh Sharma. He will be quickly joining with you. So, and after this formal introduction, myself and Venkatraman sir will see few presentations initially, and we'll go back for our works. And I hand over the session to Rahul, Karthik and Dinesh Sharma to proceed further and to give their valuable guidance towards the further improvements and everything. Okay. And Alan Paul and Dinesh Kumar, they are the Flame Association office bearers of 3rd year A section, and they will also jointly moderate with the resource persons, Karthik, Rakul and Dinesh Sharma. That's what the plan, and we will go ahead. Once the presentation is over, all other students should also be remain. Okay. Because this time, the students have really brought up a very good PPT with the latest areas. So all students must listen towards everyone PPT so that you could also gain a lot of things. With this small intro, I would like to hand over to Mr. Karthik, one of the moderator of this program. Okay, one of the I request Karthik and Rakul to jointly discuss each other and to finalize first three teams for prizes. Okay, first prize, second prize, third prize should also be given to the faculty at the end of the discussion. So you kindly go through all the PPTs and you try to evaluate each PPT and the presenters. So, and you try to give the first three prizes at the end of this discussion. Okay, I think this program is very clear and we can go ahead. Karthik, you can share something. Yes. So after you are sharing, we'll go ahead.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, please.
About what, sir? I have to
share. Yeah, you can generally talk, okay, related with Mech Talk. Otherwise, you can generally talk because you are one of the, you are the evaluator. So in what basis you will evaluate what you are expecting from the student's presentation. Yeah. Something like this, you can add and we can go ahead.
Yeah. Yes. First of all, நீங்க explain பண்ணும்போது clear-ஆ வந்துட்டு explain பண்ணுங்க and lag ஆகாதீங்க explain பண்றப்போ and பார்த்து படிக்கிற ஃபீல் இருக்கு எங்களுக்கு வந்து வரக்கூடாது நீங்க பார்த்து படிக்கிறீங்க அப்படின்ற ஃபீல் வராம உங்களால முடிஞ்ச அளவுக்கு பார்க்காம எக்ஸ்பிளைன் பண்ண ட்ரை பண்ணுங்க ஸோ வந்துட்டு உங்களுக்கு வந்துட்டு டெவலப் ஆகும் இந்த மாதிரி வந்துட்டு நம்ம கம்பெனிஸ்லாம் போகும்போது நமக்கு வந்துட்டு ப்ரெசன்டேஷன் அப்படிங்கிற ஒரு இது வரப்போ இந்த திங் வந்து நமக்கு ரொம்ப ஹெல்ப்ஃபுல்லாக இருக்கும் அப்போ வந்துட்டு நம்ம போயிட்டு ஸ்க்ரீன் பார்த்து படிக்க முடியாது ஸோ வந்துட்டு நமக்கு நம்ம மைண்ட்ல இருக்க கண்டென்ட்டை அதுக்கு சிங்க் ஆகிற மாதிரி கரெக்டாக டெலிவரி பண்ணணும் அதான் என் சைடு
Okay, and one more thing, it is already been told in the last semester, during such presentations, only the student should talk only in English. So that should also be keenly observed by the, evaluators. Okay, Rakul, Karthik and Dinesh Sharma, you please make note of this also. Okay, and yes. Alan, can we go ahead? Venkatraman sir, could you like to say anything so that we can start afterwards? Venkatraman sir?
Yes sir.
Yeah, your views please.
Good afternoon sir. Good afternoon to all the participants. I congratulate and I wish all the best for your today's event. Do your best and all the best for today's participation. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. And one thing I wanted to convey, and before beginning of the session, I would like to congratulate the efforts taken by Alan Paul, Joint Secretary of Flame, and Dinesh Kumar, Association Office Bearer of Third Year A Section. They have jointly worked a lot for last 2 weeks of time and to bring out this particular event. And I think there are 23 teams in third year A section. Among 23 teams, we had one mock presentation also day before yesterday to correct few things. Among 23, 21 teams have come forward and they have checked their audio, video and everything. And it is a very good appreciation work this time the in-charges have made, okay? And because of their hard work and the success follow, today we are in this event. Among almost 99.9% students are being participated today. All 23 teams are excellently going to present their views today. And with this few introductory notes, once again, I congratulate all the office bearers of the flame for their efforts being taken. I wish them to succeed in many more such endeavors. Okay, I think I'm handing over this to Alan Paul and Dinesh Kumar. And you can go ahead with your the agenda. Okay, one by one, team wise, you can call and they can come front and they can present. Only thing is, during presentation, the students must talk one in English and they should switch on their video also. Okay, go ahead. All the best.
Thank you so much. Yeah, good afternoon all once again. So I think all the rules should be clear to you, as Sarah has explained in a such a way. So I can directly enter into the teams. So first, the team is Parthiban S and Gokul Prasant SN, and your PPT title is Sensors Technology, right? You can start sharing your presentation with we all and you can explain. Parthiban S and Gokul Prasad SN can start sharing your PPT. Okay, you are doing next. So the next team is Gokula Krishna RK and Kavin Kumar P. Gokula Krishnan RK and Kavin Kumar P.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, you can switch on your videos as Sarah said, and you can speak in English. You can explain in English. You can start now.
And one thing, let them start to okay present. Okay, you can start to present. And Rakul and Karthik, okay, I'm just one information to you. And we try to wind up this activity before 4:30 p.m. We are almost nearing to 2:30, so we'll have it for another 2 hours. Okay, we'll leave the students by 4:30 p.m. Why? Because they have to refresh themselves and they should start to join for the Skill Rack program between 5 and 7 p.m. today. So at any cost, oh, it should not exceed by 4:30 today. That's what the plan. According to that, you manage.
Okay, sir. We will have a timer accordingly, sir.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Please. Please go ahead. Okay.
Okay, sir. Gokula Krishnan RK and Kavin Kumar can start now. Your timer is being started.
Sir, is the screen visible?
The screen is visible. You can share your PPT.
Okay. Hi, welcome. My topic is about electric vehicle and done by me and P. Kavin Kumar. Electric vehicle. Electric vehicle is a vehicle that runs by electric motor and transition motors. In electric vehicle, there is no engine, gears, such things. The main part is electric motors and batteries. The most of electric vehicles, lithium ion batteries are used. The maintenance cost is low and you can charge the electric vehicle overnight and you can travel for some small amount of distance. The electric vehicles may run different types of solar panels, fuel cells, and electric generators. Nowadays, the electric vehicles are used in electric aircraft and electric spacecraft, roads and rail vehicles. Now we see electric vehicles growth and the government incentives to increase adaptation. In late 2020s, United States and the European Union make plan and to improve the electric vehicle growth in 2020, in 2010, to increase awareness and public interest to the publics. During COVID-19, they introduced green recovery to increase the production of electric vehicles. As per COVID-19 analysis, electric vehicles are expected to increase the 2% of global share to 2016 and 22% of global share in 2030. Electric sources. Let's see electricity sources. There are three types of electricity sources: connection through generator plants, onboard generators and hybrid electric vehicles, and onboard storage. Connection to generator plants. The direct connection to generator plants is common in electric trains, trams, trolley buses. They are used in lines, thread rails, and conduct current collections. Online electric vehicles, they get electric power from the power strips buried under the road surface. In the road surface, through electromagnetic induction. Onboard generators and electric hybrid vehicles. There are three types: diesel electric transmission and petrol to electric transmission and hybrid vehicles. In diesel electric transmission, they have multiple units. And generated onboard using fuel cell vehicles used. Generated onboard vehicle using nuclear energy. Submarines and aircraft carriers, and then renewable sources such as solar power and the solar vehicle. And next, the onboard storage. The onboard storage is a charging type by using lithium-ion battery. The electricity is stored in the batteries. Yeah. And
Google, listen just a second. Just Kartik, you're audible.
Yeah. Yeah, put it in a play mode, Google, then explain.
Play mode will be available at the bottom.
In the bottom.
Play mode will be available at the bottom.
Go to the presentation slide.
Sir, I can run by own, sir.
Okay, carry on. You have
in lithium ion batteries a chemical energy stored that uses to convert electric energy.
Local.
Sir,
the screen is not visible.
Video.
Is it visible? No.
No.
No, it's not visible.
Now the screen is visible.
Visible. Now press on the play button. It will be at the bottom.
You have the play button. You can see.
No, not this. It will be at the bottom, not at
the top. Third button, dude. Third button. The top itself. Next to search. Okay.
You can go to the slide where you have lived.
Onboard storage. In the chemical energy used stored in the lithium ion battery that uses to convert the electrical energy. In five wheels used to store the energy and gives energy to engine. That is based in kinetic energy storage. And static energy stored in vehicle in onboard electric double layer capacitors. And vehicle types, Kavin Kumar will explain this up three slides. Kavin Kumar?
Yeah, I'm here.
Kavin Kumar?
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah, I have your audio.
Okay. I'm continuing from vehicle types. There are a lot of electric vehicles. They are based in electric vehicles like pure electric vehicles, hybrid EVs, plug-in electric vehicles, range extended electric vehicles, on and off-road EVs, rail-borne EVs, and space rover vehicles, and airborne EVs, seaborne EVs, electricity-powered spacecrafts. Sir, screen visible?
Yes, visible. You can go ahead.
Okay. In July 2019, Bjorn Nyland made a new distance record with the Tesla Model 3. He drove 2,781 km within 24 hours, which means 1,028 miles. In March 2020, Swiss comedian Michel Vaughan set a new motorsport world record with E-Harley Livewire within 24 hours, drove 1,723 km under standard conditions with a single drive. The record was reported all over the world.
That is, you have another 20 or 25, 30 seconds. You can conclude.
Okay. An electric vehicle battery EVB in addition to the transition battery facility systems used for industrial or vehicle or battery used to power the propulsion systems of a battery electric vehicle. EVs convert over 59% to 62% of grid energy to the wheels. Conventional gasoline vehicles convert only 17% to 21%. If you have any queries, you can ask, sir.
Yeah, you both have presented good. Karthik, what is your feedback on this?
Yeah, the presentation was good, but the little bit lag in the speaking and explaining the concepts.
So next time we try to improve it, sir.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, sir.
Thank practice it before you come to, the presentation. Do practice at least 3 to 4 times. It makes you to present it perfectly.
Okay,
sure, sir.
Yeah.
And try to avoid fillers like words like that, like all such words. Try to avoid such words.
Sure, sir.
Yeah, Dinesh, while presenting Dinesh, laptops.
Go ahead.
Yeah, instead of phone, you use laptops to present the papers like this.
Okay, sir. Next time we try to move on it, sir.
Yeah.
I think I would like to welcome Dinesh Sharma. Finally, BAD section also. He has joined right now. Dinesh Sharma, can you start your video?
Sir, just a minute, sir.
Say me hi.
Hello, sir. Sir, now I can't able to switch on the video, sir.
Okay, so that's fine.
Okay,
that's
sir.
Fine. So, Rakul, I will kindly make a note of this. He has also joined. And you all three jointly together, please take this session in a wonderful way. See that it should exit by 4:30. Okay. And you all three can plan each other and you can ask one question each. So each presentation may have three questions from your side. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, sir.
In that way, you can take it further. Thank you. We'll go ahead. Next team.
Yes, so next Parthiban, you have already said you will be doing next, right? So you can start your presentation by sharing. Parthiban, yes, and Gokul Prasad, yes, sir. Yeah, then find a way you can go on the next team. Gokul Raj B and Balasaravanan can start sharing. Gokul Raj B and Balasaravanan can start explaining your presentation. Nirmal Raj P and Bhuvati V.
Balasaravanan. Hello, Balasaravanan. If you have your PPT, and then you can start that.
Balasaravanan, is that audible?
Ah, yes, bro. I will present my screen next after. After the presenter, I will present next please, bro.
Okay. Just call your partner soon.
Okay, bro.
Nirmal Raj P and Bhupati V can start, I think.
Okay, sir.
Yes, sir.
And make your PPT. Play more, and you'll be having 5 minutes of time to explain. So timer will be started now.
Okay.
Sorry, not available in play mode, bro.
So this is not a PPT actually, this is a PDF, right?
Yeah.
So you have to make PPT. Maybe.
Okay, bro. It's okay, bro.
It's okay. You can auto, you can rotate your screen. It's in a vertical view to all of us. You can just rotate your screen.
It's okay, bro.
Yeah.
No, okay. Somewhat it's okay. You can start.
Good afternoon, one and all gathered here. I am Nirmal Raj from Mechanical Department of Knowledge Institute to present here about the AIRCAR. We saw the abstract of AIRCAR. AIRCAR is nothing but it a non-pollutant vehicle. It was introduced by Motor Development International Company. The founder of the company was Guy Negri, the Frenchman. The AIRCAR is powered by an air engine. It is a pollution-free vehicle. In the air car, the solar power is used to produce the compressed air to run the vehicle. The engine powered by compressed air stored in a gas or carbon fiber tank of 4,500 PSI. The engine has an injection similar to normal engines, but it uses specific crankshafts at and pistons, which remain at top dead center of about 70% of engine cycle. The resulting in some pollution, it is an electrical used to operate the compressor comes to from polluting power plant. Now we saw the introduction of the AIRCAR. AIRCAR is powered by an air engine.
It is an emission-free piston engine used to compress air as a fuel. It was introduced by Guy Nagre, a French engineer, in 1991. Started Motor Development International Company in Luxembourg. He invented a dual engine running on both compressed air as a regular fuel engine, then managed to create a compressed air only engine and improve his design to make it more powerful in 15 years. Other people that have been working on an idea are Armando Rucci and Angelo Di Pietro. They have two companies. Rucci started Rucci Air and Di Pietro started up an air engine. They are the seller. They are selling their engines. Engine design. It uses two expansion of compressed air to drive the piston in the modified piston engine. The efficiency of an air engine is nothing but operation is gained through the use of environmental heat at normal temperature to warm the otherwise cold expand air from the storage tank. The non-adiabatic expansion has a potential to greatly increase the efficiency of the machine. The only exhaust air is cold air. The exhaust air releases only the cold air at minus 15 degrees Celsius, which may are used for air condition in a car. The source of an air is an pressurized glasses or carbon fiber tank holding the air at around 30,000 FPa, about 20 megapascal. The air is delivered to an engine via the rather conventional injection system. The uses of air car. The uses of air car is something but in urban areas, the car is manufactured about 5-seat passengers. It moves about 360 to 320 kilometer of a storage tank. The main advantages are no roadside emission, low cost technology. The engine use food oil for lubricant. Just about 1 liter. It changes. It moves up about 50,000 kilometers. The tanks may refilling in 3 minutes at the service station, or in few hours at a home plugging the car into an electric grind vehicle or on board compressor. Now we saw the compressed air technology cars, the MDI, the Motor Development International Company allows the engines that are both non-polluting and economical and do not have a limited drive range or easy to get around the cities. The two technologies have been developed to meet different needs. Single energy compressed air engines and dual energy compressed air fuel engines. The single energy engine will be available in both Minacat and CityCats. Configured for city users, the maximum speed is only 50 km per hour. Where MDI believes polluting will soon be prohibited. The dual energy engine have been converted as a much for the city as an open road available in all MDI vehicles. Engines work exactly well compressed air while running under 50 km hour in urban areas and outside urban areas the speed over is only 50 km per hour. The engine will switch to dual fuel mode. In air car, we use both air
and time is over actually. 5 minutes is over. You can conclude. Or just thank and leave off.
Okay. Now we saw the model of an air car. The basic principle of an air car is the 34 engine and 4 cylinder which will be used for serial production. The gearbox is used in an air car is now automatic. The distribution and valves are used as well as in petrol engine, used in air engine. The models we see the air car. This is the speedometer. This is a this is a van. This is the steering of an air car. The air car we using taxi. We use as air car as a air pickup. Mini car, mini cars. Okay, conclusion. The air car is an clean, easy to drive, high performance. Okay. And the maximum speed is 20 kilometer per hour. In the future, we expect air car will come to our India. Okay. The next generation car is an electric vehicle, and next generation is air car only. Okay, thank you. Thank you for giving a wonderful opportunity to us. Thank you.
Balasaran, have your partner Gokul Raj B have come? Balasaran. Balasaran, is my voice audible?
Nirmal Raj, are you there?
Yes, sir, I'm having, sir.
Who is your partner?
Sir, Bhubadi being, sir.
Bhubadi. Please share the content and then proceed, okay? Don't do yourself a full video.
Sir, the time's up, sir.
Okay. No issue. Do it by sharing it, sir. Okay.
Okay, sir.
And I have to add some feedback, Nirmal Raj. You can add more number of image and graphical representations of your content. Moreover, text. You can just explain the text contents in words, literally. You need not type all the wordings in your PPT itself. Much amount of text is not required. You can graphically or match. In image ways, you can represent and speak on it. That's more than enough. That will be a good paper presentation.
Okay.
Yeah, this is for your future collection. That's all, nothing more than that.
Okay, sir. Next time I would do better.
Yeah, okay. So, next team, Karthik, you have something to say?
Yeah, don't see and read the PPTs like that. I told you the first itself, don't see and read. Just imagine what the things you saw in that and explain it in your way. Don't see and read.
Okay.
Yeah, next in Manish is ready to present, it seems. He has already informed. Manish, can you start sharing your screen and you can go with your explanation? I will start your timer. Manish? Yeah.
Good afternoon to all.
Your time starts now, Manish.
So, underwater welding, about overview, to improve the quality of underwater welding and accomplish a reliable, the permanent underwater wet welding compatibility has a great importance in the today's industrial facilities. The currently underwater wet welding is used for the temporary repair needs. Because of their poor quality compared to surface air welds, they obtain 80% of tensiles and 50% of ductility of the surface weld. They must be replaced as soon as possible. Next, principle of working. The work is connected to the positive sides of DC sources and the electrode to the negative. The two parts of circuit and are brought together and then slightly separated. An electricity current occurs in the gap and causes a sustained spark which melts metal, forming a weld pool. This is a working process. The power supply two electrode and work knife switch. The classification underwater welding can be classified as wet welding, dry welding. In wet welding, the welding is performed underwater directly exposed to the wet environment. In dry welding, the dry chamber is created near the area to be welded, and the welder does the job by the staying inside the chamber. Next, Pradeep will be explain.
Wet welding. The power source should be direct current machine rated at 300 or 400 amperes. Motor generator welding machines are most often used for the water underwater welding in the wet. Wet welding, most of the generator, most of the motor generator welding machines are used. The welding machine frame must be grounded to the ship. The welding circuit must include a positive type of the switch, usually a knife switch operated on the surface and commanded by the welder driver. Then the hyperbaric welding. Dry welding and hyperbaric welding are also known as, are also same. Hyperbaric welding is carried out by a chamber around the structure or bevelded. The chamber is filled with a gas, commonly helium containing a 0.5 bar of oxygen. Both helium and 0.5% of oxygen at the prevailing pressure. The habitat is sealed onto the pipeline. The pipeline, in pipeline, the habitat is sealed and filled with a breathable mixture of helium and oxygen above the ambient pressure at which the welding is to take place. This is the wet welding and the hyper welding, both the hyper welding and dry welding. Risks involved, the risks involved, the disadvantage. There is a risk to a welder driver of electric shock. Electric shock may, the welder driver have to be careful in, careful. Precautions include achieving adequate electric insulation of welding equipment, shutting off the electricity supply immediately the arc is extinguished, and the limiting the open circuit voltage of welding. Thank you.
Yeah, okay, fine, Manish, CK, and Pradeep, yes, right? Yeah, we explained it. Good, it is. So, as we said in the previous, the same feedback will be suitable for this too. So, try to avoid known amount of text. Have graphical representations, images, statistics like that, and explain all the things. You can improve your flow of speaking by continuously doing this kind of events and speaking in English. That's not a problem. Karthik and Vinay Sharma can add your views and ask your queries.
Manish?
Sulan? Yes, sir.
How deep can a welder can go and build the thing? Can you understand my question?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Just answer. Or no means no. That's all.
No, sir.
Okay. Just go through the details and the basics. You should know. You should have to prepare the basics first. Okay, and then you should proceed. Okay. Karthik. Okay, next. Karthik.
Yeah, in the last slide, you put the thank you slide, you know. Don't put designs or something like you put thank you in as like a strike on the thank you slide. So be formal and learn the basic things as Dinesh Sharma said. Before presenting a paper, you should know what the questions will ask. Will be asked by the evaluator. You must learn everything, and so that you can able to answer all questions.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
And as they both said, this paper presentations and all this kind of events being conducted to make you learn something. So you will evolve yourself. That's the main goal and motive of all these events. So just try to evolve yourself by learning things while you present.
Manish, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Just Google my question and put it in message box with the question.
Okay, sir, I will put it.
Okay. Let everyone know that.
Our next team, K Mano and B Abhinav, can start sharing your presentation. K Mano and B Abhinav can start sharing your presentation. Are you guys available or what? Mano is available.
Yeah, bro. I'm sharing. It's sharing, bro. Can you visible?
Yeah, you can start sharing. That's Abhinav, Mano.
Abhinav, in this call, bro.
Yeah, I am available.
Yeah, okay, you can start.
It's visible.
Your screen is visible, but your PPT is not. Yeah, now it is visible. You can go to slideshow. Yeah, fine. You can start now.
Hi, good afternoon, everyone. Myself, Kemal, and B, you know, we are, our topic is autonomous vehicle and how it works. This is the content introduction. What is the need of autonomous car working? Components, advantages and disadvantages. Introduction. Autonomous car is a vehicle that can drive once itself from one point to another point. No need of a driver and assisting technologies. And it is used to reduce crashes and prevent injuries and save lives. Why the autonomous car is needed? Driver is the most common of accidents. So we need the autonomous vehicle, and India contributes for around 4 or 6% of road accidents. And the improving technology will concentrating for us. So by improving this autonomous car and vehicle technology, we can reduce the percentage of accident road accidents. Okay, autonomous car use many technologies and different type of sensor to sense environment around it and make appropriate decision. Many systems are available that assist human driver like ABS and ACC, etc. Radar system in the front and rear bumpers calculate the distance to obstacle, how many meters are coming the obstacle or where are we, it's located, all the details in the radar. After this slide will be explained by
Abhinav. Good morning, I am Abhinav. I explained about the components of the autonomous vehicle. The components has been radar system, light detecting, ranging, ultrasonic sensors, the internal machine units, and the CPU computers. No, can change the slide. The working model of the vehicle. The remote sensor technology. No, can change it. And the remote sensing technologies. Measure distance, light beam, and then reflecting light. Radars. The radar systems are used to calculate the vehicle speed, self-parking, and obstacles, etc. The ultrasonic sensor measures the objects and the parking of an autonomous vehicle. Autonomous vehicle and do not need actions. The video camera has been installed on the top of the different classes. Traffic lights, and it can be used to stop or run the rather than the traffic instructions. Okay, change in the slide. It can also be used within GPS or satellites information technologies. Internal machine units. Internal machine units and electronic device makes message information, velocity and orientation, gravitational force, etc. Advantage. Hello, Mono, change CPU. CPU is a computer based than of an autonomous vehicle, and to monitor and sense the vehicle. It is very powerful than autonomous vehicle instead. The advantages of an autonomous vehicle is reduction in car accidents, to maintain the speed, optimum speed, efficient to use in highways, fuel economy, reduction in the car too. Next, can Mano explain?
You can conclude, yeah, Amino. You have another 10 seconds, you can conclude.
It is a very high process to have been failures of the tensors, which actions, loss of its privacy, and the efficient task is more stable job.
Your time over, you can stop your screen sharing. So what I have observed is you both lag in the energy you speak. Try to hold the energy so that the audience or people whomever you are sharing will be somehow observative towards you, and you will have a command over the people. And you have asked your partner to change the slide, right? Just boldly say that Mano or Abhinav. Abhinav, can you change the slide, next slide, like that? You need not lower your voice on such portions. Other than that, please don't read. You are not reading a book or a page. You are presenting something to people. So you are trying to make us understand the things what you have learned. That is the goal here. So that is not being fulfilled. You are just reading like a book. That's not required here, actually. So you have to present. This is what we are saying from all the explanations and the presentations. So Karthik and Dinesh Sharma will add to this.
Yes, this is a major problem. You just reading the presentation. Don't do like they explain something. You can read, but you can't read every time like that. Please explain something. Okay, Mano.
Yeah, bro.
Okay, Abhinav, just raise your voice and as Rakul said, just be bold. You're losing your temper. Just raise your voice and present. Okay, Abhinav?
Okay, next time I'll see.
Okay.
We like to be the problem next time in the group. Sorry.
Sure.
If you improve, that will be good for you all. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. You said about the autonomous vehicle, right? Yeah. What are the things you learned in this while preparing this PPT or in this?
We searched this topic as Chrome. We learned how the today the major problem is accidents, so we decide to rectify the accidents. We search the autonomous car, like some journals and PPTs, and we made it.
Okay, by using autonomous vehicle, we can avoid accidents 100%.
Not exactly 100%. We can reduce its of level, prevent them percentage. We reduce the percentage of road accidents.
Yeah. Then what are the advantages? Extra advantages in that the autonomous vehicle.
If any of the critical situation, our mind is not working. How happened to escape from this situation? So the autonomous, the CPU and the satellite coding will be know how to move, how to escape from the accident. So the use of autonomous vehicle.
Yeah. Okay. Learn a lot of the things like this autonomous vehicle. It will help you in future. Okay. Yeah. Learn a lot about autonomous vehicle.
Okay. Next time we will make better book.
Yeah. You're going right, but you have to explore more on autonomous vehicle. Okay. So it will help you in your future.
Okay.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Karthik. Next, before going to the next team, you guys are not switching on your videos, I think. While presenting, you can start switching on your video as the class advisor insisted. So next team is Gokul Raj, I think. Gokul Raj can start sharing your screen.
Yes, bro. Raj.
Before that, you can switch on your video, both of you.
No, we can't use camera while sharing screen, bro.
Yeah, okay, it's fine. Actually, before sharing itself, you can switch on the video from the next team. So before sharing screen, you can switch on the video.
Okay, bro.
Now you can carry on.
Good afternoon and all. I am Gokul Raj and my teammate is P. Balasaranan. Today we are going to talk about the topic of nanotechnology. Bala, you can take over, Bala.
Okay. Let's talk about introduction, organics, fundamental concept, current research, tools and technique. These are the concepts I will explain to you now. Introduction. Research and technology development at the atomic molecular or macromolecular level in the length scale of approximately 1 to 100 nanometer range, creating and using structure, device and system that have no properties and function because of their small and intermediate size. Next slide, please. Origins. From this origin, the concept that the speed nanotechnology were first discussed in 1959 by renowned physicist Richard Feynman in the talks "The Plenty Room at the Bottom," in which they described the possibility of synthesis by direct manipulation of atoms. Next slide. Fundamental concept. Nanotechnology is the multiplication of matter at a molecular or atomic level in order to produce novel material and device with their new extraordinary properties. The behavior of matter change significantly when the surface area to volume ratio increase so dramatically. Next, please. The silver nano platform for using silver nano particles as an antibacterial agent, nanoparticle based transparent sunscreen and carbon nanotubes for stain resist textiles. Next screen. Next slide, please. Current research nanotechnology, what are the carbon nanotubes, semiconductor, nanowire, 2D material, nanoplastic structure, super molecular assemblies, etc. Bottom-up approaches or self-assembly approaches to nano fabrication use chemical or physical force operating at the nano to assemble basic unit in the large structure. A top-down approach, shorter wave surface source such as extreme ultraviolet and X-ray are being developed to allow lithographic printing techniques to research dimension for 10 to 100 nanometers. Next slide, please. Next, tools and techniques. There are several important modern developments. The atomic force microscopic, the scanning tuning microscopic, various techniques of nano lithoscopic such as optical lithoscopic, X-ray lithoscopic, dip pen nano lithoscopic, ultra beam lithoscopic, etc. From the another slides, Bogudas will explain you.
I'll take over this. There are so many researches and developments held on nanotechnology. These are the companies listed below are the companies which have got patents on nanotechnology. Samsung Electronics from South Korea have got 2,578 patents for their research and development in nanotechnology. And Nippon Steel and Sumitomo Metal, Japan, they have got 1,490 patents on nanotechnology. And these are the companies who have got the patents for research and development in nanotechnology from 1970 to till now. Applications. As of August 21, 2008, the project of emerging nanotechnologies estimated that over 800 manufacturer identified nanotech products are publicly available, with ones hitting the market at the pace of 3 to 4 per week. Most of the applications are limited to the use of first generation passive nanomaterials, which includes titanium dioxide in sunscreen, cosmetics, surface coatings, and some food products. Carbon allotropes used to produce Gecko tape, silver in food packaging, clothing.
Time for your team is over.
Okay, bro. Thank you.
So, what I felt is you have downloaded this PPT, right?
No, bro.
So I can find all such words are not even understandable to you people, and you can just change, you can download, that's not a very big deal. You can download things, you can download journals, that's not an issue. So you have to change the content which will be understandable to you and as well as all the common participants.
Okay.
So this is to improve you, not as an remark.
I can understand.
Yeah, that's what. Then, as usual, don't read. All of you are doing the same. Don't read. You are adding just one or two lines to the paragraphs available over there. So don't do that. Try to speak your content, what you understood from that slide. That slide is just a key point to remember you something. You are just seeing the slide and making some points from your mind. That should be your point always. So Dinesh Sharma and Karthik will add to this.
Yeah, Google. What is the recent trends in nanotechnology?
Yes, bro.
Yeah, wow. What is the recent trend going on now with the nanotechnology?
They are using this in output.
What?
Don't waste time. If you know that, just say it, or else just say no. We don't know, bro, like that.
Bro, I can't explain, but I know it.
I don't ask you to explain. Okay, you don't know any recent trends going on now with the nanotechnology?
Till now in India, we have not attained the nanotechnology's applications, bro. These are so famous in only in Japan and South Korea, in mobile companies to build their phones.
Okay. Did you see any movies in nanotechnology use, movies, used in movies?
Used in movies.
Hollywood movies.
Big Hero 6.
Did you see Avengers?
Yes, bro.
Yeah, in that Iron Man suit lost on the end game and the
Yes, bro. Yes.
That is also nanotechnology. Yes, bro. So, all well known in that. Yes, so by using the nanotechnologies, we can able to provide much high efficient things.
Yes, bro.
So explore yourself and nanotechnology side. This will help you in the future.
Okay, bro. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah, next Parthivan and Gokul Prasad can just go with your PPT. I will start the timer. Parthivan, yes, and go. Yeah, fine.
Sir, PPT is visible, sir.
Sir, yeah, PPT visible. Is visible.
Visible, visible. You can go ahead. Timer is running.
Sir, sorry.
Yeah, your PPT is visible, okay. Parthivan.
Good afternoon to everyone ahead. Who gathered in this meeting.
Parthivan, your network lagging so much.
Prabhakaran, sir. Okay, sir. About sensor technology. Oh, yes, bro, I have low network connection. Can we do next, bro?
Okay, next team. Alan, who is next?
Sir, so Dinesh and Gopi Madhavan.
Go ahead. Without wasting time, go ahead quickly.
Sir.
Ninga, yeah, okay. Gopi Madhavan Raj team, the next team or name, so that they will be ready.
Sure, sir. We can put it in the chat box.
Followed by Yare Abdin Soltina, Anglo ready away.
Sure.
Okay.
Bro, my PPT is visible.
Yeah, visible, and I'm starting your timer. You can start now.
Oh, okay. Good afternoon to all. My name is V. Gopi Madhavan Raj from Mechanical Engineering. I am talking about the topic underwater welding. Underwater welding is the process of welding at the elevated. underwater welding is the process of welding under the elevator pressure and normally underwater. Underwater welding can either take place wet in the water or dry environment. It is predominantly referred to as hyperic welding. Hyperic welding when used in dry environment and underwater welding. The application of underwater welding, ships repair and offshore oil platform and pipelines, and steel is most common metal welded. Principle of operation. The work to be welded is connected to one side of electrical circuit and a metal electrode is to the connected other side. At the same time of top of electrode melt and the metal droplet are projected into the weld pool. The welding circuit must include usually a knife switch operated on the surface and commutated by the welder and the used for safety reason. When DC is used, the positive polarity. Positive polarity means the stem of used in electricity and magnetism and electronic signaling. This is just name of few areas. The pole with fewer electrons then has a positive polarity. And electrolysis will take places and cause rapid deterioration of any metallic component in the electrode holder. Classification. It is two classification of underwater welding: wet welding, dry welding. Wet welding. First wet welding. The welding is performed underwater, directly exposed to the wet environment. And the second one. Dry in welding. A dry chamber is created near the area to be welded and the welder does the job by staying inside the chamber. Wet welding, the name of implies underwater wet welding is done in the environment where the base metal and the arc are surrounded entirely by the water. Wet welding MMA is used. MMA means manual metal arc welding. A special electrode is used and welding and carried out manually just as one does and open air welding. The increased freedom of movement make wet welding is most effective, efficient and commonly metal method. Welding power supply is located on the surface with connecting on the driver or welder via cable. With welding power supply is used DC. With welding polarity, positive polarity. With welding AC is not used on the account of electrical safety and difficulty in maintaining on arc underwater welding. Next topic carried out, Dinesham. Dinesham.
Good afternoon to all. Myself Dinesh, mechanical department. My topic is underwater welding. Let us see about the wet welding of advantages. It is cheapest and fastest method. The tensile strength is high. It is easy to access the wet spot. It is no habitat, no construction required. It is no waste of the time. Now we see the disadvantage of wet welding. Wet welding, rapid quenching. Rapid quenching decreases impact, hydrogen impairment and the cracks. Power visibility in water. Next, see about the dry welding or hyperbaric welding. The hyperbaric welding is a welding in which a chamber is sealed around the structure of the welding and is filled with breathable gas. It is commonly used to helium conducting of bar. The bar is 0.5. Yeah. Bar of the oxygen. At the building.
Time over, Dinesh. Time over.
you can just talk. Dinesh, you can stop time out for your presentation.
Okay, bro.
So actually, Dinesh, have you had your lunch?
Yeah, yes, bro.
Dinesh.
Yeah, yes, bro.
Are you all right? You are well, right?
Yeah, I will.
But you are taking some breath while speaking while explaining the slides. You are taking breath, like deep breath you are taking. So I thought you are not feeling well like that. So don't take a breath between an explanation, though that's not necessary. You can explain casually without any nervousness.
Yeah, okay, bro.
So Dinesh Sharma and Karthik will have queries with you people.
Okay, Dinesh, just be bold and explain. You are just as Rakul said, you are just explaining lazy. Just be bold and explain to everything.
Okay.
Then carry on. Next team.
Thank you.
Next team, Nelson and Poovers.
Audible, bro?
Yes, good. You are audible. You are visible.
Very warm welcome to all. Myself, Nelson Francis, from third year mechanical. And we present about regenerative braking system. For some go-to brakes. Next slide. So first we know about what is brakes. So brakes is nothing but a brakes is a mechanical device that inhibits a motion by absorbing energy from a moving system. It is used for slowing or stopping a moving vehicle or a wheel axle or to prevent its motion. Most often application by the means of friction. Next slide. The conventional braking system. The conventional braking system uses friction to counteract the forward movement of a moving car as the brakes acts against a rub, the wheels, the extensive heat energy is created. The heat energy dissipates into the air, wasting up to 30% of the car generated powers. Regenerative braking system. First, we know the principles of regenerative braking. The regenerative braking is based on the principles of physics that states the energy cannot be destroyed. It can only be transformed from one form to another. In a traditional braking system, presencing on the brakes pedal causes a pair of brake pads in each wheel to come into contact with the surface of brake rotors. And the components of required: brake drum, friction lining, electric generator of DC motor, and linking mechanism. And this is the working diagram of a regenerative braking system. And then how does it work? The regenerative braking system is an energy required mechanism that slowly down a moving vehicle or object by converting it kinetic energy into a form that can be either used immediately or stored until end. In this mechanism, the electric traction motor uses the vehicle's movement to recover the energy that would otherwise be lost, the brakes has heat, and the common form of regenerative braking involves a electric motor functioning as an electric motor, electric generator. In electric railways, the electricity generates its feedback into the traction power supply. In battery electric, and hybrid electric vehicle, the energy is stored chemically into a battery. Next slide. The regenerative braking efforts drop off lower speeds and cannot bring a vehicle to complete half reasonably quickly with the current technology. Although some cars like that, the company of Chevrolet Bolt can bring the vehicle to a complete stop on an even surface. When the driver shows the vehicle the regenerative braking distance, then this is the refers to as on pedal driving. The effect of available is limited, and mechanically braking is still necessary for a substantial speed reduction to bring a vehicle to a stop or hold a vehicle at a standstill. Take over to power.
Yeah, there is an time is over. Your team's time is over. So, what I feel is you can have more number of images, and you need not explain all the terms with a description. You can just have a word, and you can explain that term with your own words. You need not explain all the small terms through reading that. You can explain all the small terms to your own words itself. You need not refer the slide. So that's what I wanted to say. And Dinesh and Karthik will add the points.
Thank you.
Okay, Nilsson and Poorson, what is the source of regenerative braking? Source of energy. Where it is from?
Energy recovery mechanism.
Okay. Recovery, it is a mechanism. Okay, I'm asking about the source of energy. Okay, Nilsson.
Sir, it's from electrical energy, bro.
It's okay. Okay. Next team will discuss. Just go through the Google and put it in chat box. Next team, Bhaskar, please be ready.
Next team is actually Parthiban is asking for a second. Chan Sharma, his network is okay, it seems. So if it again troubles, we can just dealing.
Okay. Let him present.
Parthiban, you can start. Bro, his voice is clear, bro. Bro, is my voice
audible?
Absolutely,
you can go ahead.
Good afternoon, everyone who gathered. Okay. Bro, thanks. Good afternoon to everyone who gathered in this meeting. Myself, Parthiban, and my supporting partner Gokul Prasad, we going to present topic on about sensor technologies. And I heartfully welcome our class advisor, Dr. K.S. Prabhakaran sir, and our senior members Karthik, Dinesh Sharma, and Rakul sir. So we look into the topic. Sensor technologies. We will talk about the type of sensors and the several applications. Let us first go through the agenda and the topics we will discuss today. First, we will cover the various terminologies used in sensor technology. Then we will go through the different types of sensors and properties required for the good sensors. And we are case further, we will discuss the nature of sensor. At last, we will look at some of the real life challenges by using sensors in industrial application and different products. Understanding this sensor technologies. What is sensor? A sensor is a device that responds to the any change in a physical phenomena or environmental variable like heat, pressure, humidity, movement, etc. Sensor is basically a part of the measurement system. It is the first element that comes in contact with the environmental variable to generate output. So sensor are present everywhere. They are embedded in our bodies, automobiles, airplanes, cellular telephones, radios, industrial plants, and countless other applications. Without the use of sensors, there would be no automation. A transducer is an electric device that converts energy from one form to another transducer. The properties required for the good sensor: accuracy. Accuracy is the capability of the winning instrument to result close true value of measurement. Quantity, it generally measures error by means of absolute errors given by measure value and true value. Relative errors given by absolute error above true value. Calibration, required for the most measuring system since the reading will drift over time. Environmental, sensors typically have a time, temperature and or humidity limits. Range, range is the minimum and maximum value of the physical variable that our sensor can sense or measure. Example, RTC for measurement of temperature as a range of 200 degrees Celsius to 800 degrees Celsius. Repeatability, the variance in the sensor's reading when a single condition is repeatedly measured. Resolution, the smallest increment the sensor can detect. Nature of the sensor, a good sensor that obeys the following rules can we see one by one. It is a sensitive measured property and it is sensitive to other properties. It does not influence the measured properties. A bad sensor has following characteristics. The sensor is not ideal. Several types of deviation that will be observed. Sensitivity may differ from value specified. This is called sensitivity error. The sensor is still linear. You can see the different types of sensors like color sensors, gas sensors, LED, proximity sensors, rain sensors, and water flow sensors, etc. IR sensor. The infrared sensors, on the other hand, is a device that can measure the distance to an object by using the sound waves. It is measure the distance by transmitting the sound wave at the specific frequency at listening for the sound wave to bounce back and which it is surrounding the basic concept of infrared sensors which is used on the obstacle detector. It is to transmit the infrared signals from the surface of the object and signals is received at the infrared receiver. This is the you can see the diagram of the infrared Google Prasad.
Yeah, actually time is over, Parthiban.
Okay, sir.
So what I felt was the PPT creation. You have used both dark colors in fonts and as well as your background is also dark. Try to use different color in background and in font. It should be a background should be light and the color of font should be dark. It can be vice versa, no problem in that. So try to use like that while you are virtually presenting, it will be nice and we can observe much things. So I feel that, and as usual, you are also just reading and running. Or you are running while you explain. You are running like anything. You need not run. Try to explain a thing and take the time required. Don't run. You can reduce the slide, but you need not run while you explain. That's what I feel. So Dinesh Sharma and Dharti will add. Yeah, what?
Bro, due to not much time, so I can cover the more things.
Yeah, actually 5 minutes was the time I have given. So within that, you can just move on with the main things.
Okay, bro.
Okay, Parthiban. By which sensor you can measure the temperature?
By IR sensor.
IR sensor. Then?
The temperature sensors which is measured by a thermistor, I think so.
Okay. Just go through the, you are correct, but just go through the, some more time. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. Then your font is disturbing our eyes. Your font is, there is no quality in that. Please be check your quality of font.
But due to no network connection, that problem will
appear. Okay, if you're presenting in offline means it is okay, but you're presenting it now online, your PPT should be in a good quality now.
Okay, bro.
Okay. Please be make sure your quality of fonts and the PPT. Okay. The next team, please speak.
Our next team will be Bhaskar. Bhaskar, can you share your screen?
Bro, are you visible?
The screen is visible and your diamonds being started.
Okay. Good afternoon to one and all. I am Bhaskar. My teammate is Bhubalan. We are going to talking about 3D printing technology. Content of the above the slide. First of all, history of 3D printing and what is 3D printing, working and principle, types of 3D printing, application, advantage and disadvantage, and future uses. History of 3D printing. The first oldest 3D printing was made in Japanese inventor in Hideo Kodama in 1981. In 3 years later, 1984, Charlie Sull made 3D printing history by inventing stereography. Stereography is nothing but to create design 3D model using digital acrylic based material known as photopolymer. It is a volatile liquid photopolymer with a UV laser. The shape of your 3D model design. Needless to say, this new technology was big news to inventors. Next, what is 3D printing? 3D printing or additive manufacturing is also known as process of making three-dimensional solid object from a digital life. To creation of 3D printer object is achieved using additive process. 3D printing to produce any object in short time using polymer. 3D printing to produce compact shape using less material than traditional manufacturing methods. And its working principle, first of all, it starts with the 3D model. You can app to create one from the ground upon or downloaded the 3D gallery. as a 3D printer adds filament to build the object layer to layer during the 3D printing process. In the way of manufacturing the object, erase this scratch. After that is added to the next layer above the first one, so the intended object is growing up layer by layer with the help of a 3D printing.
Next, types of 3D printing. Types of 3D printing: stereolithography, selective laser sintering, fused deposition modeling, digital light process, multi-jet fusion, polyjet, direct metal laser sintering, electron beam melting. Applications: education, prototyping and manufacturing, medicine, construction, art and jewelry. Advantage and disadvantages: flexible design, cost effect, minimizing waste, strong and lightweight part, fast design and production. What are the cons of 3D printing? Limited material, large volumes, reduction in manufacturing jobs, design inaccuracy, copyright issues.
Futures of 3D printing. 3D printing will become a mainstream technology for serial production, and mostly 3D printing will become smarter and using many department in the future. Dental 3D printer will continue to mature. Composite 3D printer will offer a big market opportunity, and automation will become a key focus for the industry, and additive manufacturing landscape will become more competitive. That's all.
Yeah, actually you have completed within the time. That's really a good part about your presentation. What I want to say is that you can have much clarity when you speak. Both of you can have much clarity. And Dinesh Sharma will have a question with you.
Yeah, I'm Karthik here. Who's the presenter? Bhupal. Yeah. Do you think the 3D printer is much faster than the traditional printing? Traditional production?
Yeah, bro.
3D.
Okay, you're sure about it?
3D print.
Yeah. 3D printing is much faster and efficient than the our traditional production. Okay. Do you get it? What I'm asking? Colin, are you there?
Yes, bro.
Yeah, did you get it? What I'm asking? Rakul, is I'm audible?
Yes, Karthik, you are audible actually.
Why?
Anudhi, we are not... Do you understand the
question? Yeah, I'm Anudhi. Rakul, I'm from the laptop, Anudipak laptop, so my name is...
Okay, Bhupalan.
Tell bro.
What is the most common material used for 3D printing? Most common material, in which material you can make a 3D printing? If you know the answer, just say me, or just say no. No issue then.
No.
Okay. Bhaskar, or you know that?
Bro, mostly use the photopolymer material.
Okay. There is a many materials, and ABS filament is a most common material for the 3D printing. Just go through the basics, okay, and the types of material. Okay.
Okay, bro.
Okay. And the next team. Next team, please proceed your PPT.
The next team is Gopul K and Deepan. You can start sharing with your presentation.
Yes, bro. Bro.
Yeah. Your screen is visible. Go to the play mode. Google, your voice is not audible.
No, it's visible.
Yeah, now it's visible.
I'm going to talk about contents or production of three laws of robotics. Why robot is used, types of robot, components of robot, advantage and future scopes. In the third branches deal with the design, construction, sensing and analyzing process. These are collectively different fields of engineering that covers meeting of human characteristics. Need working the three robot they are given by human beings. Order would conflict the first law. Third law of robotics must be it's not conflict first law and second law. Why robot use high efficiency and adaptability? There are different types of robots such as mobile robot, rolling robot, walking robot, stationary robot, autonomous robot and remote control robot. Mobile robot, the robot are able to move and perform searching tasks. The example is Mars Explorer, which is specially designed for raw Mars surface. Mobile robot used for survey purpose where people cannot go. Next, rolling robot. Rolling robot have a wheel to move around the land. They are useful only in flat surface. The rocky surface is not useful. Flat surface are the territory. Next, walking robot. The robot have like to move in rocky surface and difficult to enter with the wheel. Robot have shifting balance, so they keep them from tumbling. The development of legged robot is modeled from insects and crownfish. Stationary robot. This type of robot perform repetitive tasks would ever moving an inch. Most of robots are working in industry settings, especially in repetitive tasks duty in case the tasks are done, the robot can be reprogrammed to perform other tasks. Autonomous robot. Autonomous robot are self-supporting robot. Autonomous robot, they run on their own brain. Next, remote control robot. A robot is operated by a transmitting device. In most cases, the remote. The robot are called remote control robot. There is a direct interaction between human and robot. By K. Google.
Bro. Components of robot. Component of robots, structures, powers, power source, activation, sensing, manipulation, locomotion. Even next. Next slide. Next slide, Steven.
Steven, are you there?
Steven.
Yes, bro.
Okay, next slide.
It's visible structure shared.
Structure of the robot is usually mechanical and it is called kinetic chain. Chain can form a link activation join and follow one or more degree of freedom. Next slide. Power source. There are many suitable power supply needed for motors. Typical power requirement for ranges 3 volt to 24 volt as 200 to 220 volt AC supply must be modified and is accumulated. The accumulators are the muscles of robot power. The 220 volt supply AC supply must be modified to the heat need to our machines. Battery can be also in the robot running robots. And the robots are driven different motors, DC motors, stepper motors, servo motors. Next. Even accumulators are the muscles of the accumulators are muscles of the robot. Fast control.
Gokul, is this accumulator? Gokul?
Bro?
Is this accumulator?
Accumulation. Sorry, bro.
Dhiri Sharma, time over. You can ask your query, Dhiri Sharma. Gokul, time is over.
Okay.
So even I myself felt Gokul, you are somehow laggy in pronouncing the words and identifying the words. Okay. And it's not typical, it's actually typical. Try to improve your pronunciation of words. That makes you sound good. So while you pronounce good, your voice should be good and your way of expressing will be good. So try to concentrate on your pronunciation. And then, as usual, don't try to read whatever is being typed over there. It is not the content you speak from a slide. It is just a point of remembrance. You have to just take a word, just take a keyword and explain it of it. So it is more required.
Okay, bro.
That's what Dinesh Sharma and Karthik will continue.
Yeah,
Dinesh Sharma.
Yeah. Don't go for much faster while explaining something. Take your own time and explain it clearly so that the people to listening towards you can understand what you are saying. You are going much faster, so we can't get it, and you are changing the slides more frequently. So explaining the things is much clear. I need clarity, some more clarity on your explanation.
Okay, bro. I collect it.
Yeah. And yeah, as Rakul said, take a note of it on your pronunciation. Must be more important. Okay.
Okay, bro.
Yeah.
Gokul, Deepan Kumar.
Yes, bro.
Types of joints in robot, mechanical joints. Types of mechanical joints in robots. Can you able to say?
Bro.
Okay. Just Google it and put it in chat box. Next team, please.
Okay.
The next team is Dinesh Kumar A and Parthipan M. You can start.
Bro, screen visible?
Yes, go ahead.
Good afternoon to all present here. Myself Parthiban from Mechanical. Today we are going to present about topic of digital manufacturing. Let's see. Introduction, see what is digital manufacturing and then historical manufacturing, benefits of digital manufacturing, three dimensional. Three dimensions of digital manufacturing, concept of digital manufacturing, and advantage, disadvantage, conclusion. Let's see what is digital manufacturing. Digital manufacturing is nothing but the use of integrated computer-based system comprised of simulation, three-dimensional visualization. And digital manufacturing to create a product manufacturing simultaneously. And digital manufacturing as a speed, as a spread rapidly through industries such as aerospace and defense. Digital manufacturing is application of computer systems to manufacturing service, supply of chains, products and processes. Digital manufacturing can be considered as the last decades. It can reduce the product development time and good quality products and fast response to the markets. Historical manufacturing. In historical manufacturing, the process is very linear. There are needs more labors, and to make a product is very difficult in those days. And today manufacturing's material cost is rising and supply constraints. The labor cost also increasing. The productions are over capacity and profit are very less. Outsourcing, suppression of the designers and make has low investments. Future manufacturing. In future manufacturing, they are fully automated by using the AI and robotics, etc. And digital links between the design and fabrication. The connected machine, factories, and supply the chains. Some benefits of the digital manufacturing by using work more efficiency, reduce errors, and improve product quality, faster time to supply the product, and learning on the jobs, sir, specialized knowledge. The remaining slide, Dinesh Kumar will.
Now the previous page.
Now 1 minute.
Now see the three dimensions of the digital manufacturing. There is a product life cycle. Their product is life cycle means starting to ending period of their product. Then smart factory. A smart factory is fully automated and equipment resources
are Dinesh?
In real
Dinesh?
Time.
Dinesh Kumar, is it audible? Are you wearing headphone?
Yes, bro.
Your mic is doing some problem. Just remove it and present your PPT. Remove your headphone. Okay. Now you can present.
Audible.
Yes. Yeah, now you are audible. Now you can present the PPT.
Then we see value cycle management allow for an optimal process integrated, decrease the inventories, better production, and enhance the customer satisfaction in a minimum resource. The next slide. Now see concept of digital manufacturing. There is a four concept. First, control centered digital manufacturing. Then design centered digital manufacturing. Then management centered digital manufacturing. Manufacturing centered digital manufacturing. The manufacturing centered digital manufacturing contain all over the above three concepts. The next slide. You see the advantages in digital manufacturing. There is a low cost and increasing profit, and in cycle time is reduced in short period to take market products. And disadvantage, the machine have a lot of energy to produce a product. The 3D printings take long time to produce a product. Then it's not a beneficial for a mass production. Next slide. conclusion, digital manufacturing incorporate technologies for a virtual representation for a factories, building a resources, machine systems, equipment, labors, staffs and their skills as well as integrated of a product and process development through a modeling and simulation. It is a key for adapt and based on a modern tools and technicals for engineering and control, supervision and management in the network. This is a new era of manufacturing in the digital manufacturing. Thank you. Thank you for the opportunity.
Yeah, okay. Dinesh Sharma, you can just ask the question.
Okay, Parthiban.
Yes, bro.
Can you mention some of the companies of digital manufacturing tools?
Sir, automotive companies.
Okay, automotive companies, okay. Can you mention the name of the companies?
Yes, sir. Toyota.
Okay.
Sir, all car companies are using, sir. Automobile companies.
Okay. Okay, just go through it.
Yeah, Parthiban. Did you hear me?
Sir, hear me.
Yeah. In digital manufacturing, you are saying, you know, for digital manufacturing, what are the other things we need to implement? Like, you have to implement the machine learning concepts also there. You aware of that?
Sir, no, sir. Not aware.
Yeah, kindly aware of, make note of it and learn a lot about digital manufacturing because the future is going through towards it. So kindly explore it.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Yeah.
And the next team is Darun Prasad and anyone.
Okay, boy.
Yeah, okay, you can start. I will start the timer. Quick.
Can you even share the PPT? Change the slide in the landscape. Okay. Good afternoon to one and all present here. I am Darun Prasad and my partner Inivan from third year mechanical A section. Today's topic is underrated engineering techs. First, electric plant. It means we can get electricity from plant. Now we will see about working of this technology. During photosynthesis, plant produce organic material with the help of sunlight. That organic material stored into the air roots, bacteria present in roots will break down that organic compound into electron and photon. The main component of electricity is electron and photon. So we use cathode and anode, we can get electricity. University of Washington conducted a research. They use maple trees and get 1.5 volts of electric current. Next advantages, it promotes agriculture, it is eco-friendly to environment, reduction of methane emission because we use that electron and photon, so it reduces methane emission. It is easy to use, we can use in indoor also. Up till in the place someone use kerosene lamp, in that area we can use this technology and make small light can make a big difference. They have high efficiency in agriculture area because there are more number of plant and trees, so we can get more electricity. Next technology is about drones. In 1935, first drone was initially launched. Initially, they named a drone as Working Bee, formerly known as unmanned aerial vehicle. Drone fly with the help of a software controller system and the embedded system and some sensors and the GPS. Next, construction of drones. Frame, motor, electronic control, battery, propeller and radio transmitter. Next, we will see about types of drones and their uses. Single rotor drones are hard to control, so we use it only for scanning. Next, multi rotor drones are easy to control with more stability, so we can use it for aerial photography, videography, and aerial mapping. Next, fixed wing road can able to fly a long distance, so we can use it in inspection for a pipeline and power line. Fixed wing hybrid drones are used for delivering the product. Micro drones are small in size, so we use it for spying purpose. GPS drones is used for locating area. Next, photography drones are used for taking photograph. Next, racing drones are able to fly at maximum speed, so we use it for racing purpose. Next. In this lockdown and COVID situation, these drones will help much as possible. First, counting head count. Next, monitoring social distance. Ensure the security. Next, measure the body temperature without interruption of human contact. Next, spraying disinfectant. Next, delivery a medical or sufficient product. Essential supplies for people. Next, improvement and create awareness. Next, communicate through speaker. Next, preventing theft and unlawful activity. These all activities are done by without human interruption. So it was a very awesome technology in today. Some online platform offered many drone programming technology. It gives more job opportunities. One college in America, they introduced drone engineering courses for 3 years. Next, advantages. Lightweight and easy to transport. Low cost, high resolution image. Save time and save life. It can enter any environment. There no need to experienced pilot. It has high safety. Next, we will see about application we can use in aerial photography, shipping and delivery, geographic mapping, disaster management, precision agriculture, research and rescue, weather forecast, wildlife monitoring, firefighting, and security. Over to anyone.
Good afternoon, sir and friends. I will continue from Argon Engineering. It's one of the Department of Engineering which deals with the partial amount of technical engineering and medical science. We can only know its importance of the emergency medical care purposes only. These engineering graduates are also called as organ engineers, and their work is to mature and grow the important organs of human body and to protect and preserve them for years and years for the entire life of human with the help of most valuable and engineered machines. These machines are only handled by maintained and safety organ engineers.
Time over. Can you hear me? Time over.
Yes,
bro. Bro, only few more slides are there, bro.
Yeah,
it's okay. More than 8 teams are
but
there.
But time over. 5 minutes is over. 5 minutes is over, actually. You can just...
get your conclusion, bitch.
Stop, sir.
Okay, and finally, we are asking a question that who is an engineer? In my point, serving a billionaire to make them feel a luxurious life in with the use of technology, it's not engineering, but helping the incapable people to lead a normal life with the same technology, and that is called engineers. Thank you.
So actually, what I feel about this presentation is the title of your... paper presentation is really something different, and your content is also good, but if you have done in a different way, if you have done in a good way of expressing and explaining, it might be a best presentation. So your content and presentation title is good. Actually, we have to improve your level of explanation, and you need not read as line by lines. We have to explain. That's what is required. Then Dinesh Sharma and Karthik will add their words on it.
Okay, Inyan, go to your introduction, bitch.
Jee, bro, organ engineering.
Organ engineering. Okay. When you are doing presentation, you would just explain about the things, which are all the main things you are going to do. Okay. There is no idea about your presentation. Your topic is good, Niels, but you should have to explain the things what you have to explain in the in between the presentation. Okay. Can you understand my?
Yes, brother. That will take a little bit more time. That's why I'm not able to do it properly.
Okay. Next time you should do that. Okay.
Okay.
Please.
Your presentation was good, and you need of as Rakul said, you need to improve your explanation skills. I said Lara before for the first and second things. Practice more. It makes you to deliver the contents better. Okay.
Bro. Thanks.
Yeah.
Okay. Next, Jeeva Guru Prasad is supposed to share your slide. Jeeva Guru Prasad. Jeeva Guru Prasad, are you available? You can start sharing your slide. Your slide is visible. Just to get into play mode, you're fine. I will start the timer. Your time starts now.
Good afternoon to all present in this meeting. I am Guru to present the Industry 4.0, the accounting industries, induction, industrial revolution. Industry 4.0 6 design principles, building blocks of Industry 4.0, impact, advantages and disadvantages. Introduction. Industry 4.0 is a paradigm of connecting different kinds of physical devices with embedded electronics to network or internet, man to machine or machine to man, and facilitating IT-enabled mass customization in manufacturing. Next, industrial revolution. Industry 1.0 is introduced mechanical production, machines powered by water and steam, and industry 2.0 introduced mass production lines powered by electric energy, and industry 3.0 introduced the use of electronics and IT further progressing autonomous production, and now industry 4.0 is based on cyber physical systems. The cyber physical system is directly record physical data from using sensors. Next, the phases of three industrial revolutions. The first industry 1.0 is started in 1962-1840. Use in mechanical production, railways and steam engine. Industry 3.0 starts in 1872-1940. They can produce mass production electricity and assembly line. And industry 3.0 started in 1962-2010. They can use computers, semiconductors, and mainframe computing, personal devices and internet. And now industry 4.0 is now in using CPS, cyber physical system. Next, my friend Jeeva will present.
Good afternoon to all. We go to six design principles of industry 4.0. First, the interoperability, the ability of the cyber physical systems, humans and smart actors to connect and communicate with each other through the Internet of Things and the Internet of Services. Next is virtualization. A virtual copy of the smart factory is created by the linking sensor data with the virtual plant models and simulation models. Third one is decentralization. The ability of cyber physical systems within smart factories to make decisions on their own Next slide. Fourth one is real-time capability. The capability to collect and analyze data and provide the insights immediately. And the fifth one is service orientations, offering of service through the cyber internet of services. Next one is modularity, flexible adaptation of smart factories for changing requirements of individual models. Next, building blocks of Industry 4.0. First one is autonomous robots and simulation, horizontal vertical system integration, industrial Internet of Things, cyber security, additive MFG, augmented reality, and big data analysis. Next, the impact of Industry 4.0. This first one is economy and business, and national and global society and individuals. The next one is top 10 skills to be relevanted in Industry 4.0. In 2020 and 2015, these types: complex problem solving, critical thinking, creativity, people management, coordinating with others, emotional intelligence, judgment and decision making, navigation, conductivity, flexibility. Next one, do this up. So next slide.
Actually, your time got over. Just you can stop sharing. Time got over. And the presentation was good, but you can have some changes in this presentation. You have explained all the basic Industry 1.0, Industry 2.0, and Industry 3.0. All that are actually not necessary. It's actually a history, right? You need not repeat the old things. You can just enter into Industry 4.0, which is currently happening, and you can have a future vision of next level of revolution. So that will be a point of idea sharing or an PPT presentation. So from the next paper presentation, you can avoid the histories. That's not much necessary. Just we have to focus on the future or the present. That's very much essential. So do you understand what they say?
Yes, probably.
Yeah, Industry 1.0, 2.0 and 3.0 are already we have experience, and we all know what all such stuff is. But 4.0 is not everyone is aware of. So you can explain that, and you can even think of what will be the effective 5.0 of revolution like that. You can just project the view like that. That will be better. That will project you as an intellect. Friend, you get me?
Okay.
Yeah, okay. Dinesh Sharma and Karthik will add a point on the feedback. And
Guru Prasad, are you aware of BS6?
Yes.
Are you aware of the BS6?
It's a BS, I know.
BS6.
BS6.
Are you aware of that in the vehicles?
Yes.
Okay. What is the major advantage of BS6?
To avoid pollution.
Okay. Good. Okay. Next, Karthi.
Yeah. You were explaining about the Industrial 4.0. What did you think about it while you were preparing this? Why? Which makes you to do this? Take your this topic.
No one will do this topic. So only we take a new topic. That's only we take the super point.
Oh, okay. You are not interested. You are interestedly take this topic, or only others not doing so. Only I am taking this topic like that.
So that's interesting. A little bit I have interest there. My partner will tell me it will take Industry 4.0.
Okay. Any topic you will take, but you have to work with an interest to present in a presenting a paper, while presenting a paper, you have to be interested in that. So the clarification of explanation is much better.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. Next, P.S. Raghuman team can start your presentation as soon as possible. P.S. Raghuman.
Yes, dude.
Now you can start presenting. I will start the timer.
Screen visible?
Screen is visible.
I am Prayas. Good afternoon to every one of you. My name is Prayas.
Yes, Raghuman. This is a PPT or a PDF?
PPT.
PPT. Then why it is not getting into play mode? Have you opened this in WPS Office or any other external application?
DOS will open.
Yeah, fine. Can you just rotate your screen? Rotate. You can go ahead.
My partner is Dharani Dharan. We are talk about the electrical vehicle. Why we can't take it electrical? The next 15 years, only electrical vehicle only in our countries, our nations. Dharani Dharan.
What is an electric vehicle? An electric car is an automobile that is propelled by one electric motor or more, using electrical energy stored in batteries or another energy storage device. Economic benefits. Volatile gas price reduces dependence on the pump, lower fueling cost, off-peak charge time of use rates, lower maintenance cost, no more oil changes, reduce UPS.
And also the government will be increasing the benefits in offers. When you can be buying an electrical vehicle, you have in free insurance 5 years, and we have road tax free and extra benefits for the new vehicles in EV vehicles.
Plug-in electric vehicles in 101. There are currently more than 20 different electric EV models on the market offered by a variety of manufacturing such as Ford, Honda, Mercedes, Chevrolet, BMW, Nissan, Toyota, Tesla.
Yes, we can be able to read. If you have any explanation, please explain it. Why? Because there is no time for other teammates. If you only reading means, don't do that. Let's skip it and explain the things which you know that. Okay.
The battery electrical vehicle. When the battery, the current source of the battery is stored in energy, the converter into the energy is moved into inverter, the converter into the electrical, into AC current. AC current will be drive the motor. The motor connected to the flywheel to rotate the wheel. There are three types of electrical vehicles: hybrid and plug-in hybrid in electrical vehicle. The hybrid vehicles are the models are Toyotas. It can be hybrid. The plug-in hybrid is gasoline in plus or electrical. The electrical is purely electrical only. The conventional gases, there are movement of the electrical vehicles. The battery power, it can be fully electrical. It can be moved in only in electrical. But the plug-in hybrid is a gasoline and electrical motor can be moved. But the conventional hybrid, it can be only major movement of gasoline and hybrid electrical motor. It can be moved in short distance only. The conventional is a gasoline. It can be only movement of fuel. The major advantage of electrical vehicle, better for the environment. The electrical is less expensive and less maintenance cost of these vehicles. And the potential tax or credit extra. The changing can be take off lot of times. And also in our India, our first bus was launched in Himachal Pradesh. In our Tamil Nadu also. Also the ex-chief minister.
Okay, fine. Go to the conclusion.
Disadvantage of the electrical vehicle, the electric is not, electricity is not free, the short driving range on speed, longer recharging time, the silent and disadvantage, and normally two seats only in the electrical vehicle, it can be run in weight cages. Thank you.
Yeah. Those who have completed, you guys can leave as your advice mentioned, you are having skill track program. Those who have completed the presentation can leave the Google Meet. And whoever is remaining, who has the training can come forward to present your presentations before 5 p.m. So as you have training, all such students and team can present now itself. So you can rise, and those who have a training at 5 p.m. still track training, and those who have completed can leave now. So it's nearly 4:30. Yeah, Ilavasan has raised his hand. Kishore has raised his hand. So completed students can leave. As your advisor mentioned, it's nearly 4:30. You can leave, and remaining students, those who have training, can present now itself. Those who don't have training can wait for some time. You can just start your screen presentation. Whomever having training by 5 p.m., you can start your screen presentation.
The completed students, please note out your mistakes and problems. After this presentation, you should recover your problems. Then only you can. And those who completed, please exit.
Completed students can leave the platform. No issues. And who is ever ready now? Two people have raised the hand, and now you have raised down. So whomever is ready, just share your screen. Who has training by 5 p.m. can share your screen now. Kishore,
so I could like to
are you ready,
sharing.
Kishore?
Oh, yes, I'm ready.
Yeah, you can start. I will start the timer.
I think I have shared the screen. So good afternoon, I am Kishore and he is Kirti Vasan. So thanks for giving this wonderful opportunity. I am going to present a PPT on the topic of smart wheelchair. So I am really happy to say that this is a project I am recently working on it, and we are going to see what are the content on the topic that we are going to see in this PPT. So these are the contents about and the required equipments, design, why, uses of this project, reference. So I hand it over to Kirti Vasan to start this.
Good evening, friends. The object of this project is to help physically challenged people. It will basically very helpful to who cannot able to walk. One can use this wheelchair for various purposes. This chair can be used as a panic lamp. This wheelchair also has a dead light last, but not the least, the wheelchair is automatically identify the obstacles, and it makes decision to go with the obstacle from the free path. The required equipments for wheelchair is Arduino UNO, motor driver, Bluetooth module, ultrasonic sensor, DC motor, lithium battery, breadboard, etc., and jumper wire. I will hand it to Kishore.
Thank you, Kirti Vasan. This is the graphical diagram for designing the program. So first, this is the diagram. This is the model that we are going to do, and this is the parts and how I connected. This is a breadboard and ultrasonic sensor. Ultrasonic sensor is used to measure distance by ultrasonic wave, and it gives the sound by using buzzers. And we have connected a LiPo battery, that is 1100 battery, to Arduino. This is an UNO, that is a first Arduino board. This is the first Arduino board, and it has a drive motor to give the correct electricity to the motor. We have used a drive motor, and here DC motors are used. This is 12 volt battery, and push button is used to connect to the Arduino board. So this is a simple diagram, and I have used this. So why this project? So this project, in America we have many disabilities person, that is 125 people are having a disability in that. So we are significantly working on this project to give this more efficient. With this project we are more efficient, and using the sensors it can sense the object near it, so it can sense alarm, so that it have device. So here you can notice that the Bluetooth module is there. Using Bluetooth module you have connected to the phone, and you can locate the wheelchair where it is, so that you can move the wheelchair using your phone or anything else. I hand it over to the Kitty Vasan to say users of the project.
Uses of the project. These filters are used as a medical, used in medical devices. The patients with impairment in mobility are persist by the clinicians to use wheelchair for assisting the movement independently. In the present competitive world, every individual wish to engage themselves either in jobs or educational activities irrespective of the disability. People with disability are often at risk of health problems, which could have great impact on physical, mental, emotional and social activities. Therefore they look for an improved right in members and caretakers, promoting self-reliance.
So these are the books I have referred for this project, that is a remote lock system using Bluetooth communication, and using the Department of Electrical Science, that book named Arduino. I have go through this book for this project. So thanks for giving this wonderful opportunity to make this PPT significant. Thank you.
Yeah, really very good presentation, and you have done in correct timing, within 5 minutes, correct exact 5 minutes. So really that is grateful. And it's your project, your father's project, right?
Yes, sir. Yeah,
it's really great. And you both have a knowledge of the work what he is doing. And that's really nice to know that you have a base and core knowledge to the project. Dinesh Sharma will have a query with you people. Dinesh Sharma.
Okay, good presentation. Next
team, please.
Good presentation.
Thank you, bro.
Next, Alan Paul, you can start sharing your screen and present your PPT.
Okay, bro.
Next team, visible, bro.
Yes, you can go ahead.
Yes, screen visible.
Okay. Good evening, all. My name is Alan Paul. My team is Tejas Kathi. We both are 100%. Toxic problems in constantly variable transmission, commonly called as the CVT transmission used in most vehicles. The preview will be about the origin of the CVT transmission and the founder, and where it first came into use, and the pros and cons, the working of it in the modern day CVT uses. Origin, in 1899, Milton Reeves was the person who formed the CVT. He used this CVT transmission for saw milling,
he used to cut big saw. Then we thought of installing the CVT transmission in vehicles. In that way, he founded the company, Reeves Auto Car Company. Company's name got its name by, since the car has 8 wheels, it got the name Auto Car. This was the first car in the history that was using CVT transmission. The most commonly and widely used CVT transmission is the fully based CVT. The CVT, this type of CVT is still in use and is the most efficient of the CVTs. It generally consists of two cylindrical drums. Each have its own variable length. The one which has the drive contracts and the wheel end expands so that the torque increases. The working of the CVT is very simple. It just uses the centrifugal force of the cylindrical drum. As the RPM of the engine increases, the centrifugal force increases so that the drums move up from each other, so that the diameter of the pulley becomes smaller. Similarly, at the opposite end, when the speed increases, the both drums come closer, such by increasing the diameter of the pulley. This results in the increasing torque and speed at a perfect ratio. This GIF will show you how the contraction and expansion of the drums changes the diameter of the pulley. This is by which the throttle affects the speed of the vehicle. Pros and cons will be explained by Ms. Karthik.
And good cost in the continuous variation. The efficiency of power conversion is above 8%. The continuous transmissions are always. So the engine slow and consistent, avoiding the high engine speeds. Continuously varying transmission also have lower production cost because they have fewer moving parts than traditional automatics. Alan, next. Modern day. The Honda models with the CVT are the most reliable among all the lines, and the CVT life expectancy is the longest. You can see the diagram on the modern day CVT. Thank you.
Okay, Karthik, what is torque? Karthik or Alan Paul?
Torque is the turning effort which is put in a car. The efficiently turning of a wheel is the torque.
Okay, okay. Not like that. Just go through the Google, okay? Okay, next team. Kavin Venkat.
Bro, am I seen visible?
Yes, you are visible.
Okay. Good evening to one and all present here. We are going to talk about magnetic levitation train. I am Kavin Venkat and my partner Paridila. So Paridila will start about introduction.
Introduction. We are trying to develop an idea to run a train based on the technology of magnetic. The magnetic levitation train will occur by a magnetic force and the train will run some distance above the car. In that way, you will be able to totally remove the problem of current problem. In current situation, these are the problems we are facing in our situation, which are current land transportation is slow, land is interval friction, time is expensive, air and land travel takes up a lot of fuel. For the above problem, this may be a solution. Reduce friction for land travel or destroy the railroad track. Process is simpler than making a plane by staying on land is safe.
Bharati, Bharati, can you audible me? Bharati, why your voice making some noise? Are you wearing headphone?
Ah, yes, too.
Just remove it and explain, please.
Now waiting. Is it now okay, bro?
Okay, okay. Carry on.
Okay.
Now it's better. Now
in detail. The nanotransportation train is one of the fastest transport media in the whole world. The maximum speed reached for a nanotransportation train has been 581 km per hour in a jala. The nanotransportation train uses magnets to reach a very high velocity. It doesn't touch the floor, it levitates because of magnets. Magnetic levitation train uses magnets to levitate and propel the train forward. If there is no friction, this train can reach high speed. Mostly, it is a safe and efficient way to travel. Two types are developed in the world, which are Transrapid and Pure Shinkansen. Transrapid is a German high-speed monorail train, and the Pure Shinkansen is a landed Japanese monorail line designed to ultimately connect Tokyo, Nagoya, and Osaka. So the following topics will be explained.
Transrapid, German high-speed monorail train using magnetic levitation because on a 1935 planned for the transrapid system started in 1969 within test faculty for the system in Islam German completed in 1987. Tokyo Shinkansen is planned in Japanese manual line designing in ultimate contact Tokyo, Nagoya and Osaka is in interval planned route by the Shinkansen station in Tokyo in Nagoya station in Nagoya.
Leading coming. Go to the control.
Motor in magnetic limitation.
Coming.
Sir, yes, okay. Conclusion.
Okay.
There are definitely a better way to travel. Currently, test track are being built in America. Magnetic levitation transport has been questionable in future. Thank you, bro. Give you a wonderful opportunity.
So, Bharati, I noticed that your voice level is low. And I think your confidence level is also somehow low. I'm not sure about that, but your voice level is low. You have to improve your volume in all the forums wherever you speak. That's what I observed at you. And you can, you both can improve your skills in explaining and speaking.
Okay.
Okay,
bro.
So, Vinay Sharma, is there something to add? Otherwise, we can go for the next team.
Kavin, you're making mistake by reading itself. Don't do it like that, okay? Next time.
Sir, okay, bro.
Okay, next. Abhishek and Ajit Kumar.
Abhishek and Ajit Kumar. Yeah, you can start sharing your screen. And all the completed students can leave the Google Meet platform. Abhishek and Ajit Kumar. You can share the screen. You will be
between. Hello. Hello. Is this audible?
The audible. You can share your screen. Yeah.
Okay.
The audible. Your screen is visible. You can start explaining.
Okay, brother. Yeah. Good evening, all. Myself Abhishek, and here is my friend Ajit Kumar. We are going to present a PPT about electric vehicle. Ajit, can you give the intro of the electric vehicle?
The invention of the first model electric vehicle is attributed to various people. In 1828, Andrei Jerlik invented an early type of electric motor and created a small model car powered by his new motor. In between 1832 and 1839, Scottish inventor Robert Anderson also invented a crude electric carriage. In 1835, Professor Sibelius study of Groningen, the Netherlands, and is Alstom Christopher Becker from Germany has created a small-scale electric car powered by non-rechargeable primary cells. Basic main components of electric cars: traction battery pack, power inverter, controller, galaxy traction motor. Object.
Yeah. Nowadays, in this world, in this society, we need a eco-friendly environment. So that's why, apart from others, as an automobile industry and a mechanical industry, we need a eco-friendly environment. So that's why we are manufacturing the electric vehicles. Nowadays, electric cars are big. Hello. Nowadays, electric cars are making big waves in the automobile world. So we need a vehicle like noise-free, pollution-free, and a high-performance vehicle are expected nowadays. So that's why in this presentation, we are going to see about Tesla S model car. How it is performant. So in this analyzing its technology, we are seeing that there are three components are there, as usual in the electric cars, such as induction motor, an inverter, and a lithium ion battery power source. So in this week, we are going to see about induction motor. Ajit, show the induction motor. This is an induction motor. It is also called as powerhouse of the electric vehicle. There are in this induction motor, there are two components. We are saying that as stator and rotor. Ajit, now you are
the range of induction motor is 0 to 18,000 rpm. The difference between IC engine and induction motor, the IC engine speed range, the efficiency is only in 2000 to 4000 rpm, but the induction motor, the efficiency is 0 to 18,000 rpm.
Yeah, this is called inverter. It is also called as brain of the electric vehicle, because it converts the DC current from the lithium ion battery cells from and converted into AC power supply in the induction motor.
This is the battery pack of Tesla model S. We see coolant passage in this package.
The battery is nothing but bus. It's just a collection of lithium battery nowadays we are using in our daily lives. Here we are use glycol coolant to pass through metallic inner tubes gap between the cells. Ajit, next please. Next. In this there are a radiator to pass through the heat away from the vehicles. Also, there is an innovation of Tesla saying that by using small cells instead of few big cells, so it is effective coolant is guaranteed. So that's why in this there are 16 pellets are there and more than 7000 lithium cells are combination of 7000 cells are here in this battery.
This is the diagram, 3D animation diagram, single spin transition and a reverse gear.
Yeah, your time is over now.
Okay.
You can stop sharing. Now, next to Giridhar and Nilavasan, you can be ready. And Vinayasana, if you have any query, you can ask Vinayasana.
No, next, please.
Next, yeah, okay. Next team, Giridharan and Ilavarasan. You can start sharing. Abhishek and Ajit, you can leave, and you have done good. You can leave.
Okay, brother.
Yeah.
Giridhar, Ilavasan, you can start sharing your presentation.
Yeah, yeah. Good evening, bro.
The screen is visible. Put it in play mode. Play mode. Yeah, fine. You can start.
Good evening, bro. My name is Silavarsan and my partner name is Giridharan from Mechanical Department. My topic is electrical vehicle to handle to Giridharan.
It's a content page on the introduction is given by electrical vehicle working. An electrical vehicle works on a basic principle of science, conversion of energy. Electrical energy is converted into mechanical energy. There is a motor used in the electrical system to carry on this duty of conversion. Motors can be of various types. The electrical motor gets energy from controller, which regulates the amount of power based on the driver's use of accelerator pedal. The electrical car, also known as electrical vehicle of EV, uses energy stored in it is rechargeable batteries, which are recharged by common. What's the next page? Need of electric cars contributed to cleaner air to preserve the fossil fuels, less maintenance, more efficient, cost effective. On the battery level, in an electric car vehicle, the auxiliary battery provides electricity to power vehicle accessories. Charge port. The charge port allows the vehicle to contain an electrical power supply in order to charge the traction battery pack. That's the next page. Leverson.
Bro, the types of the electrical cars are the three types. The plug-in hybrid electric car, battery electric car, bro. Plug-in hybrid electric car. The both the electric motors and internal combustion engine need to run the cars. The combustion engines are using to charge the batteries. The rechargeable the batteries recharge in internal combustion engine and regenerating brakings. Hybrid electrical cars using small electrical batteries to internal combustion engines provide increasing fuel efficiency and recharge the both gas oil and the engine and regenerating brakings. Battery electrical cars. The battery electrical vehicles are electrical, no internal combustion engine, to need to long time of rechargeable time, 7 to 8 hours, in order to run 80 pulse per mils. Advantage is cheap to running becomes the low rates of electrical than petrol, zero harmful emission, better than environmental, near 100% recycled batteries, reduce noise pollution and can be recharged almost anywhere to urban areas. Disadvantage, time to recharge in batteries more, less charging stations, combustion engines cost the batteries providing to body heavy, increasing the net weight of cars. Conclusion, with this welcome, we come to following the factor numbers of expert vehicles, the doubling on the road in near futures and need to for alternative energies, very elevated and promised to returns. Important to product vehicles to do less, have a longer range and use less energies. Lower of emissions and local greenhouse efficiency, increasing to overall energy efficiency of car. Thank you, bro.
Yeah, okay. Next thing, you should not read what this in the slide, you should not see and read. Try to develop your own explanation part. And next team can start sharing. You can leave. The completed team can leave. Next team can start sharing your screen. Naganand and Harish.
You can start sharing.
Bro, visible bro.
Very good afternoon to Ananda here. We are going
to it's visible.
Oh, okay, bro. And we are going to explain about autonomous vehicle. Me and my partner name Harris. Introduction. The word autonomous derived from a Greek word. Auto plus our self-governance. It's a vehicle that from one place to another place without any assistance from the driver and operated by an autopilot system. This next. History. This is further invented by Google engineer Sebastian of the Standard Artificial Intelligence Laboratory of a Google CTO. NHTSA Department of Motor Vehicle issues for the first license from an autonomous car in 2012. The license was issued to a Toyota Motor with Google's experiment driverless technology. On the vehicle hardcore are LiDAR, radar, camera, ultrasonic sensor, GPS and CPU. The LiDAR sensor. The LiDAR light detecting and ranging sensor is a scanner mounted on the roof of the vehicle which are rotated. Laser beam moved around the car. The radar system is an object detector system that uses radar waves to detect the range speed of object, measure the distance by various objects and allow the system to reduce the speed of the car or fix it in front of the bumper and one in the rear bumper. The camera are installed at the top of the front glass of the car that detects the traffic light and any moving object in front of the car. It also is to identify the road markings and traffic signals by the artificial intelligence software. Ultrasonic sensor are mounted on the wheel of a vehicle, may be used to measure the position of the object close to a vehicle such as curbs. Used for detecting that object, measure the position of the other vehicles during parking.
Next is GPS. GPS is a global positioning system. GPS sensor provide the car with real-time information about surrounding. The source of destination is marked on the map and the car uses GPS to navigate itself without human interruption. CPU is a brain of the car. All the data obtained from each and every sensor system is fed to the central computer. The central computer is very powerful processing unit mounted on the inside of the vehicle. Next advantage. Reduction in car accident, efficient use of highway, reduction in the need for traffic police and vehicle insurance, reduction in car theft due to the vehicle self-awareness. Disadvantage, chance of hacking, cost is high, need of cyber security, failure of sensor leads to accident.
Okay, thank you. As usual, try to have more images on and graphical representations on your PPT and use your own explanation. Do not read such words. Just have keywords to remember. That's what I want to say. And you are done. Okay. Well, you can leave now.
Okay, thank you.
Is any other team to present?
I think everyone have completed, Sharma.
Then why?
Alan, everyone have completed, right?
Yeah, no. This is the last team. No one else.
Yeah, okay. I will remove all. Fine. Thank you for the coordination, Karthik, Alan, and Dinesh Sharma. Really, I am thankful and grateful towards your efforts and all the students and third year class advisor KSP sir. Really, I'm thankful to all your efforts. Let us meet in another exciting event. Thank you all.
Thank you. Thank you so much.